everybody. Good afternoon. I am Jeffrey Jansen. Today is, I believe, the 17th of November, 2017. I wanted to give a brief explanation of the motivational posts I put up the last few minutes and the reason why I put them up there. I'm always reminding people of things that are toxic in our life, of things that we need to get away from in order to become more. All right. And what we always forget is we get around people a lot of times and we're like flies on a wall to certain people in our lives because they constantly are putting us down, reminding us of our past, constantly always remind us, hey, I've always been there for you, but remember when you did this, this, and this, or, oh, you made the paper for this, or, oh my gosh, can you believe you did this in the past, or I heard somebody talking. You know what? Those are the very people that are hurting us. The ones that are going out of their way to let us know about what people are saying about us. Here's what a friend does. Here's what somebody that's going to build you up will do. First off, they're not going to remind you of your past. Second, if somebody starts talking about you, they're going to either politely say, I don't wish to talk about that. Or they're going to say, that's my friend. That's okay. I don't care. Or they're going to walk out of the room of whoever that person is. The person that sits there and wants to listen to the gossip about you just to go running back to you to create even more drama and gossip and rumors, those are not your friends. Those are not people that have your best interest at heart. A true friend, a true motivational person, is someone that will build you up when you're at your lowest. A person that's there when you're at the bottom and they have nothing to give you except friendship, that's your friend. Somebody that goes out of their way to remind you, oh, I heard somebody talking about you today, but I put them in their place. You know, that's a person looking for recognition. That's a person looking to build on your weakness to keep their morals high. And the thing about it is it's not morals. A lot of people fall into a category. They hang around people all the time that are toxic. They hang around people that have given up on their dreams. They have given up. All they have is excuses on why they can't do something. And they'll give you some of the greatest excuses in the world. The only thing about it is, you gotta look at yourself like a child. Yesterday I put on there, a child does not fall down as they're learning to walk and say, oh, I'm done and give up. A child will keep getting up until they learn to walk. Why? Because no one told them they couldn't do it. No one told them, oh, sorry, there's people out there running marathons and, you know, you're just never going to be as fast as them. No one ever went out of their way to teach a child that they can't walk. So that child falls, gets back up, falls, gets back up. They don't care. They want to walk. They don't want to crawl anymore. They want to walk. So when you're going out there and you're trying to get a job, you're trying to do business, you're trying to get a sale, you're trying to get your college education, you're trying to pass high school, you gotta quit listening to all the negative people. You gotta quit being negative yourself. If somebody starts talking trash about one of your friends, who cares? Water off a duck's back. And in case you ever need to know what that analogy means, when a duck goes in the water, its feathers have an oily substance on it that when the water hits it, it goes off. So a duck remains dry and the down underneath its feathers stay dry. You need to stay dry every day because it's going to pour down rain on you. And those people that want to remind you time and time, or they go and they're like, oh, did you hear about this? You know what? Those people are toxic. I don't even have to go any further because we all know what I'm talking about. We all know who those people are in our lives. And everybody has them. It's the same people that want to go to the bars every night of the week. It's the same people that go into church and will make fun of somebody in church because of the clothing they wear, not realizing church has nothing to do with the kind of clothes you wear. They're the same people that want to go to church and get recognition and they want to be all God Almighty, but then they go sin the second they get out of church because they don't mean anything by going to church. These are the same people that have to go to family functions just to get the latest gossip and drama. They have to watch TV. They got to look up negative stuff on the news. They got to go online. They got to find the latest gossip because they've already given up on their own dreams. Now they want to pull everybody else down with them. And the thing about it is, it could be very small hints that they're giving you that these people do not have your best interests at heart. And a lot of people tell me, oh, they're my friends. Right. But they're also your friends that gave up on their own dreams, and they're gonna do everything in their power to pull you down and make sure you cannot live your dreams or be able to accomplish anything. There was a long jumper in the Olympics one year. And I believe it was in the 1980s. And I apologize for not having it up the back, okay? Before then, all the way back to Olympic times, the long jump, everybody would only break it by a couple inches. Nobody could get a world record and nobody could jump higher. Well, there was one particular Olympic athlete that got out there and he went to do the long jump. Now, nobody told him he couldn't do it. He didn't care what people said or thought. He went out to do this long jump, and he didn't just break the record or the world record. He destroyed it. Why? And then what's funny is he's not the inspiration. Yes, he is an inspiration for doing it when nobody else could. But after he was doing it, then everybody else started doing it too. Why? Because no one set their goals that high. They never think they could do it anymore. Everybody held everybody back. Oh, you're never going to be able to go 32 feet. You might be able to go, 20 feet, but you're never going to go 30. Second that person goes 30, and everybody's like, you'll never go 30. The fastest race cars in the world at one time were very, very slow. No one ever thought that we could basically break the sound barrier on a wheeled vehicle. Nobody ever thought that somebody like Michael Jordan would ever exist and could like defy gravity. Nobody ever thought we'd land a person on the moon. It took people to think outside the box. Now everybody's like, I'm not those people. Yes, you are. Every one of you are those people. It's just you've given up because everybody told you you couldn't do it. I'm here today to tell you you can do it. I'm here to tell you today that if you want to be president of the United States, you can do it. If you want to be a millionaire, you can do it. If you just want to go help people, you can do it. If you want to go find a cure for cancer, quit listening about all the pharmaceutical crap and go out and find a cure for cancer. If you want to go and get those jobs, you can do it. Who cares what everybody else thinks? Who cares what your friends are telling you? Who cares if somebody says, well, they're not hiring? Great, go find out yourself. Because only a fool will not do it for themselves. Quit listening to everybody that tells you, oh, I don't want that. Oh, they give you every excuse in the world. And then the very people that will follow you are the same people that were negative to you. Be the leader. Be the follower. Quit listening to the drama. That's the reason why I watch all these people put this negative crap on Facebook and I'm laughing. Because they're going nowhere with their lives. They want to call out their exes. They want, you know what? The people that are going somewhere are the ones that refuse to basically be fed into all of the drama. They're the ones that keep ahead of it. They're the ones that I don't care if that person did anything. Guess what? They didn't do it to me. And you know, I know something. This person is good. And anymore, I hate to tell you, we don't know who's being honest and who's not. There are people out there that are purposely doing things just to hurt other people. And they're trying to find everybody's weakness. That's what some of your closest friends are doing to you. They're finding your weakness. They're capitalizing on it. And while you're down in the press, they're there with their hand on, oh, don't worry, I'm here for you. Because they don't want you to get up. They don't want you to outshine them. They don't want you to have more than them. They're going to pull you down every chance they get. They do not want to promote anybody. They don't want to emphasize anybody. They don't want to put anybody on a pedestal but themselves. And the second that you get away from them, you're going to find out that you are the North Light. You are the brightest star in the sky. Because now you're surrounded with all these other stars. And every one of you shines bright because you're just now basically telling each other, hey, let's do this, let's do that, let's go do it, let's read this book, let's do that book. I have people flat out tell me, and you're where you're at right now. Oh, well, I don't need to go to a meeting. Great. Consistency. These people have no consistency. Second somebody tells them, oh, it's a scam, it's a pyramid. Oh, you don't want to work for that person. They harass everybody. Oh, you don't want to go there. Oh, lawyers suck. Oh, that business driving truck. Oh, nope, you don't get any money. Everything's got negativity to it. Why don't you look at the positive aspects? And if something's not there, bring it. Be the person that is the change for the better. Be the person that is the change for the better. If your spouse, if your ex, somebody else talking negative about you, talk positive about them. Why? Not because you like them, but because you don't want to fall into that trap of he said, she said. If you're somebody's being nasty with your kids, teach your kids to go up to them and say, hey, it's okay, I'll still be your friend. I just don't want to hang around you. Okay? We don't have to go tattle on everyone. We don't have to go do all this negative stuff. We don't have to run everything in the ground. You know what? Sometimes the best thing we can do is show kindness where kindness has never existed before. We show faith where faith has never existed before. We show a new path for those that do nothing except hear negativity. Show them a way of positive. And you want to know something? It's not easy because it's so much easier downing on everybody than being the person. If you stick your head out of a crowd, I've learned a long time ago, everybody and their brother is going to pull you down. Everybody and their brother is going to throw tomatoes at you. But what if you bring everybody out of the crowd with you? And you want to know something? Pretty soon, those other people are sitting on the sides like, well, maybe what I'm doing is wrong. I'm going to go back to a movie called Monsters, Inc. I know it sounds silly, and then I'm going to get off here. Monsters, Inc. is about a movie where they had to scare every little kid. Bruh! You know, they had to scare all these little kids. Just scare them. And it developed energy for the monster world. And nobody thought, living outside the box, like, maybe if we did something else. Well, they were having an energy crisis, an energy shortage. They couldn't scare people too much. So somebody had to think outside the box. Somebody had to think differently. Okay? Elon Musk thinks outside the box. Let's get away from gasoline fuels and let's go with electric. So let's think outside the box. And Monster Inc., all of a sudden they said, hey, if we make kids laugh, we get 3 to 4 times more energy than when we scare them. Laughter is positive reinforcement. Happiness is a positive reinforcement. And in Monsters, Inc., it could power their entire world. And you know what? It's easier to get somebody to laugh than it is to make somebody sad. It's easier to be kind and show happiness and try to get people to laugh than it is to show negativity and cruel. You want to know something? All these comedians that took their negativity to a whole different world and want to use sex and drugs and all this other stuff, they're not funny anymore. Why? Because they're real people that have been hurt in that stuff. But if you can get somebody to laugh over positive stuff and positive reinforcement, that changes the world. You can change the world. You just don't know it because you're hanging around the wrong people. You're hanging around the people that like negativity. You're hanging around people that like to drink all the time, that like to do drugs. You're hanging around people, they're content working in a factory, make a minimum wage, and they don't think anything else is good enough for them. But because they've never tried, they're afraid to live outside the box, so they need to bring everybody else down with them. If you need an example, there are millions of them out there. But the problem? Are not them. The problem is you. You need to get around the people that can show positive reinforcement. You need to get away from the drama. You need to get away from the naysayers. You need to get away from the bars. You need to get away from the alcohol. You need to get away from the drugs. You need to get away from the people that are constantly just negative, 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 negative. And you need to surround yourself with people that build you up, and they are going to build you up day after day after day. My name is Jeffrey Jansen. I want you to surround yourself with people that believe in you, that will not tarnish your dreams, that will basically push you to get ahead. You're going to trip and fall, and yeah, you're going to fail many times. But once you learn to walk, all it takes is that one time to walk. Remember, a child falls many times, not knowing, well, nobody told me I couldn't walk. But he fell so many times. But when he walks, now he's going to learn to skip, run, jump, and play. And pretty soon, they're going to be doing backflips. Be the child that learns to walk and quit listening to everybody that says you can't do it. Because you can. I don't care what it is. You can do it. And if you don't think you can, then it's never going to happen. The long jumper, look him up in the Olympics. Broke the record by so much. Look at Michael Phelps. Nobody in the world thought any of these records could be broken. Nobody thought you could get more gold medals. All of a sudden, he destroyed everybody in the world of swimming because nobody told him he couldn't. And the ones that did, he ignored. So how are you any different? It may be that your thing may not be swimming. Your thing might be long jump. It may be business. It may be sales. It may be opening a business on your own. It may be being a better parent. It may be something that we haven't even thought of yet. Colonel Sanders was living out of his car at the age of 60. And now KFC is all over the place. That's really good chicken. Okay? There was 3 founders of Apple. The 3rd one sold out. Didn't think his product would go anywhere. He'd be a billionaire today if he didn't sell out. But the other two believed in their product. They believed in themselves, and they believed in not giving up. Okay? Bill Gates came along with Microsoft, but he did so many great things before Microsoft. Elon Musk doing all the cars. Okay? Virgin Mobile. Okay? They started out as something small. You got to understand, there's so many stories out there from poverty to being able to help the world. And you just don't know if that's you or not because you have people telling you you can't do it. But I believe you can. My name is Jeffrey Jansen. I will talk to everybody later. God bless. We'll talk to everybody soon. Bye now.